This one's an interesting one. Mums with violent partners could be unfairly jailed under new laws which make a failure to report child sex abuse to police illegal in Victoria. The warning comes from victim support groups who argue a number of women might be too afraid for their own safety to turn in their abusive partners. The new law follows recommendations handed down after Victoria's inquiry into child sex abuse and carries a 3-year jail term. Joe, it seems these women are between a rock and a hard place.
Yeah, well, I mean, it's obviously you can't help but feel a huge amount of sympathy for anyone who's in an abusive relationship, but you cannot say... Firstly, women have to be empowered one way or another by themselves or by others to not be in abusive relationships in the first place. You have to get out. You absolutely have to get out. And yes, there are huge economic costs often associated with that. Yes, there are often other things, but anything is better than staying in an abusive relationship. And certainly you often see it's only when that sort of Rubicon is crossed and an abusive partner turns on the kids that many women do stand up and leave. But frankly, to say that, you know, you're going to not report a case of child abuse or child sex abuse by your partner because you are scared for your own safety, I'm sorry, it is not an excuse.
Oh, I don't... I think that's a bit harsh because I think, yes, this is all well and good to say this is what you must do, you will face a jail term if you don't. But for many of these women, they're in this terrible vortex of violence and abuse.
Like, so just let the kids
but they're not thinking straight. So rather than punishing these women, can't we look at ways to support them? Perhaps there's an option of some groups have suggested that these women could report it anonymously so they don't feel more at risk that their name isn't put out there. I really think we need to look at ways that we can empower women to get out of those situations rather than blaming them more and more.
Just think how difficult it is. If we think back to that girl, she came from Canada, and the bloke threw her over the balcony, remember? And she died. Mm. And here in Sydney it was. And she wrote to her mother that she was scared for her safety. Everyone knew she was scared for her safety, and yet for some reason that girl didn't leave. There were no children involved in this case. There's something.
And she'd seen a counsellor
too. There's something that happens in these relationships. I don't know that it's just abuse. Mm. I mean, I'm not a psychiatrist, so I don't know all that. But it's almost like they have a control over the person that makes it very difficult. But as I understand this Victorian legislation, if a woman is truly scared about her safety, she won't be sent to jail.
That's right. Yeah, I think the jail thing is just simply a sort of a signal that this is how serious it is. And I suspect for many women and for many families, that sort of almost forced first step could probably be the best thing that's ever happened to them, because once you do make contact with the police or authorities, it then will expose you to all the support networks that are available that you don't feel like you have access to when you're isolated in a controlling, abusive relationship.
If you don't earn money, if you have no income of your own and you're totally dependent on this bloke, it's a very big step for a woman to have to
pay. Yes, but you cannot allow your children to be abused.
I agree with you, Joe, but you've got to put yourself you've got to think of yourself as the woman. You know, it's all very well for us to say, you've got to do this and you've got to do that.
I understand.
But we know how hard it is.
I understand how difficult it is.
And especially if you feel that your partner is going to murder you. And your children.
Speak up, Shari.
You don't understand, and I assume none of us understand how hard it is. And when a woman's in this position, you can't go and threaten her with jail. You just can't. You've got to give her the support and the help to let her leave, you know, and the counselling and the networks and the safe houses. But jail's not going to work. She's already scared enough.
We are talking about the kids here.
Well, I've been close to it in a number of different ways, and you can't threaten someone who's already a victim of awful circumstances with jail without giving them adequate support. Mm-hmm. And it's not there because everything is stretched, and you know we see women die every single week.
Joe is right. Once the abuser goes to the children, it's usually the catalyst that makes a woman act.
That's right. I think it would only be in the most unusual circumstances that a jail term would ever be exposed. I think what the purpose of this is obviously to create that first point of contact between an abused woman and the people who can help her.